Welcome to today's episode of Class B Confessions, where we answer your frequently asked questions about living in a Class B RV.
We've been living in our Airstream Interstate for over 2 years now, and we can't wait to share what we've learned with you.
My name's Aaron, this is my wife Chris, who's Irene, and let's get into it.
Today's question is from Amy Snyder. Amy is one of our super fans, and she always leaves positive comments. So thank you, Amy, for that. And her question today, hey, just curious what you hold your Berkey water filter system in place with while you travel.
Okay, before we answer that direct question, we're going to get into just a little bit on why we even chose the Berkey or how we came about having it. So back in 2017 and 2018, when we were researching this lifestyle, if you watched any review out there or anything on van life or RVing, the Berkey was it. You had to have a Berkey.
The Berkey is the bee's knees for van lifers.
Absolutely. It was the best system out there, along with a Wii Boost and a fruit hammock.
Got to get that banana hammock.
You can't say banana hammock.
Why?
And we wholeheartedly bought into it right away, and before we even bought the van, we knew 100% we were gonna get a Berkey. Hands down, deal done. So when we actually got the van and looking around our space, there was nowhere to put a Berkey. We had no idea if it was gonna fit on our countertop, and there surely was no obvious place to hold it in place and transport it. So in our house, we actually had a Brita water filter system. It had the extended 6-month filters, and it was the square Brita pitcher system. And when we took that out of our fridge and brought it into the van to see where it would fit, it slid perfectly into the cabinet.
And we have our Brita filter. Not everybody that lives in a van has to have a Berkey filter.
So that kind of put the kibosh to the Berkey. At least for the time being. So after about a year and a half of travel, we really started to realize the amount of sketchy water places, water fills, that we were going around the country and filling up with.
Mm-hmm.
Anywhere from, you know, random campgrounds to rest stops to gas stations to just a random spigot that you read a review on Campendium or something like that.
And when we were in the state of Arizona, like, everybody's buying bottled water. They have those jugged water dispensers everywhere. And we're like, why is everybody paying for gallon water here? Like, what's the deal with the water? So we researched it. And of course, yeah, some areas have high salt. Some areas have high this or that. You never really know what's in the drinking water in the tap. So we definitely were like, okay, we need to take it to the next level.
Yeah, and we were kind of putting up with our Brita filter system the whole time. So it had these 6-month filters, and for us, we drink a lot of water, so they never lasted 6 months. It was more like a month or two, maybe. And then towards the end, we ran into this batch, this bad, defective batch of filters. Do you remember?
Yeah, it was horrible.
So I would squirrel away at least like 6 or 7 of these filters, like, all around the van. And they're not big, so, you know, you just kind of tuck them in cup holders and here and there underneath the seat. And they would be bad out of the box.
Yeah, we'd install them, you'd prime them, you'd do whatever you got to do, and then they just wouldn't drip water through. So
yeah.
Not only were we storing these filters all over the van, buying them in bulk because we breezed through them at such a high rate, then we got to this point where they didn't even work, and we were starting to just get frustrated with the entire setup.
While we resisted the urge to get the fruit hammock, we did end up finally getting a double-tiered fruit basket, which fit on our countertop perfectly and allowed us to store the extra produce that we wanted. So the water filter was in the cabinet, and the fruit basket was up on top of the counter, and everything was perfect. But because of all the filter woes we were having with that Brita pitcher, I started looking back at that Berkey filter system again, and I put one in the cart. I started watching it, and just a few short weeks later, COVID hit, and along with the great 2020 TP shortage. Along with any type of prepping or survival product or gear out there, the Berkey water filter was on the short list, and it was actually becoming very hard to find. So we immediately at that point said, yep, we're just going to get one. We don't know what's going on. grab some toilet paper and get a Berkey.
At the time, millions of RVers were getting displaced because they were getting kicked out of parks. And, you know, when the government was, or the states were pushing people on the streets, they didn't really realize a lot of full-timers don't have a home to go to. So displacement was a big fear of ours, especially with our small tanks. We were kind of picturing ourselves and preparing for any Mad Max type situation in the van, out collecting water from a stream. Who knows? Like, that time at the beginning of COVID was pretty scary for everybody, not knowing how extreme it would get. So that was a big scare that we had in the back of our mind, was just, we got to make sure that we can put water, any type of water, through our filter and feel safe.
Now, before we talk about where we store it and how we store it, let's just go over some of the stuff in the website real quick that makes the Berkey so appealing to so many thousands of people. So right off the bat on the website, you can see it removes over 200 unsafe contaminants, which just makes you feel good right there. The sizing on these is pretty cool too. They go from 1.5 gallons all the way up to 6 gallons. And ours is the travel Berkey. It's the smallest one, the 1.5 gallon, which works pretty well for the two of us. And we would absolutely want a bigger one if we had more space. If we were in a house, I think we would get probably a much larger one.
Yeah, right away my eyeballs, as I'm peeking, I'm definitely gravitated towards that, like, 4.5 gallon to 6 gallon, those two top of the tier for size. That would be amazing.
Yeah, really, really nice. But we just fill up ours maybe 2 to 3 times per day. Pricing on these range from $249 all the way up to $690. So they are pretty expensive, but once you hear how long these things last, it really is a lot more cost effective than you think, especially when you're talking about buying bottled water. So some of the things that these Berkey filters remove are viruses, bacteria like salmonella.
That's interesting that it can remove salmonella.
Yeah. Inorganic minerals like chlorine and chloride, heavy metals like aluminum and cadmium and vanadium and lead, mercury. And you can't forget about things like microorganisms like E. coli. And interestingly enough, it removes pharmaceutical drug contaminants like caffeine, prednisone, and ibuprofen.
Oh my God.
Things like that, which is interesting. Another cool thing about these filters is each black filter inside the Berkey, which the smallest one has 2, and it goes up from there. But each black filter has the capability of doing 3,000 gallons of water. And the filters are so durable that you can clean them up to 100 times, which we're gonna get into cleaning these things next.
Today is cleaning day for our Berkey. And we actually didn't even realize when we purchased the Berkey that cleaning would be involved. And about 4 months into it, we noticed the water started to had a taste to it. And more importantly, the drip slowed down. And we even have water, like, just kind of sitting up here all the time because the filters are so dirty, it can't even drip. So to cleaning your Berkey, there are 2 different steps. One is cleaning the chamber, and then the second part is cleaning the filters themselves. So we're just going to unscrew the filters. I'm just going to set them on a plate. And we're going to clean out the inside. And for this, you just want to use some mild, soapy, warm water. And I'm using a sponge. It's just a regular scratch-free Scotch sponge. Onto the actual filters now. I'm gonna pull these things off, these gaskets, because this area is super grody. Just touching it is like slimy. When you wash these, you wanna make sure you have the stem side pointing up and clean the entire length of all sides of the filter, but give extra special attention to the area up here, which is actually the bottom of the filter while it's in position. So this is where the water really sits and gets grimy. Look at all the grit coming off of this. So Berkey recommends that you clean your filters once every 6 months. We have discovered for the two of us and our higher water consumption that every 4 months is good. Probably we could even do 3 months because we do stretch it out a little bit longer than what we should. So you might find yourself somewhere in that 3 month to 6 month range. And again, on the chamber, they recommend 1 month on the water chamber. For those of you that may not know how a Berkey system works, it's two chambers. You have your bottom chamber and your top chamber. The bottom chamber is where all of the filtered water drips down and collects. The top chamber is where your filters are. So you pour whatever water in that you want to filter in the top, and it sits in the top until it drips through the filter process. So two chambers. So again, with travel, just make sure that your water is only in the lower chamber. Here is where we store our Berkey while we're set up to camp. So this is our in-use position. We like to keep one of our little finger towels that we also use in the restroom as a slider so that we can easily slide it back and forth, because we're constantly coming here with our bottle and filling it up while it's at this spot. So we like to have the towel on there so that it can slide back in here, because having that little water spout, you can catch your hip on it. And to answer Amy's exact question more specifically, when we travel, we put this on the floor in the restroom and we put the spout in a corner so that it doesn't have access for other objects to accidentally hit this. And when it's in that corner, it's nice and tight. This is gripping it to the floor. And then usually when we're traveling, especially when we're boondocking, we have other water bags in there and the floor gets pretty crowded. So everything is wedged in there and it keeps everything in place from roaming around, tipping around while we're driving. We've only had an incident one time with water spilling because we had water up top. It was like recently put in before we started traveling, and now we never fill this prior to travel. If there's no water up in the top vessel, all the water is down below, and then it's bottom heavy, so you don't have any spilling. But it is comforting to have it in the wet bath just in case the nozzle were to get pulled on something and accidentally open. You'll know that it's in a safe spot that won't get any electronics or fabrics or anything wet that you don't want to get water damage on. Now, obviously at first sound, storing your drinking water in the restroom isn't our number one choice. We did explore other ideas for alternative ways to travel with it. You know, we talked about, do we want to drill in here, put some straps so that we could strap it against the wall? We really did not want to do any drilling into this area. Also, things like two-sided tape or like double-sided tape, adhesive, that could turn out to be a disaster if it were to fail. So we avoided that idea. We also tried to come in to this storage compartment. This is where we used to keep our Brita filter. The Brita filter fit right in here perfectly. The Berkey is too tall. So Aaron spent about an entire day wrestling to get this piece out, this shelf, just so that we could put the Berkey in here. But this shelf is like impossible to remove. It's in there pretty tight, and the people who built it did not intend for that to ever come out. So this was a no, that was a no, and it just came down to, we really do feel the most comfortable in the wet bath. Again, if there is any type of a disaster that's an accident, it's the best place for that to happen. While we are boondocking, we use our onboard water. We talk a lot about how we bring additional fresh water on board because our freshwater tank just is a little bit too small to keep us out in the boonies for a good week. So we like to use these bags, and these little guys actually are super convenient and my favorite way to fill the Berkey, because they just are so easy to pour in. We also have our other storage, our hard case water bottle, the blue guy that's in here. This one is a little bit more difficult to put in here, especially when this is full. of 6 gallons. It's heavy and it's just awkward, but we do make it work. We usually put this down on the floor and then this turns into a spout and we get it in there no problem without a mess. It just takes a little bit more wrestling, especially the first few fills as you get the weight down on this.
So in closing, guys, water is extremely important. Coach Chris always talks about getting your water in.
Yes, I need to give a spiel on this. Thanks so much for reminding me.
I didn't know there was going to be a spiel.
Yes, water is one of the most important things that you can do right now to improve your everyday health and wellness. In fact, it is the very first thing that I practice with my clients when they come on board is the practice of drinking your water every day. And a great number for you to target is 100 ounces up to a gallon a day. Now, obviously, there's a lot of people that are far from that, so don't kill yourself trying to hit that number. Start with wherever you are and add on 10 ounces and then keep adding on incremental improvements until you get there. But water is very much related to a whole slew of important benefits, one of them, which is weight loss, and that's usually the one that makes people drink more.
Okay, back to the Berkey. So in closing, we really do like the Berkey. And I honestly wish we would have gotten it earlier. It was just the sizing and the travel with it, with the two pieces and kind of the extra tall height that we didn't know where we were going to put it. I'm really glad we have it right now. And if you don't have one or are thinking about one, it is a really great option to, I think, get the best portable drinking system and not have like the big built-in type of systems that are also great to have too, but this one's just a little bit easier.
It's very practical for everybody.
Absolutely. So thanks again, Amy, for asking that question, and we really appreciate everybody tuning in, and we'll check you on the next video.
Bye. Don't remember when.